Hello and welcome back to this 11th module on manufacturing systems technology. We were discussing in the last lecture how to do hermit cubic spline fit on situations when you have multiple points and you have at least two endpoints to which a certain line or a certain expression needs to be fitted. And also not only you have the points on the ends but also the slopes at the ends. And we were trying to formulate a numerical problem where we wanted to actually see a realistic situation as given here, where there are two points, point 1 and point 2, whose coordinates and the slopes on those particular points are given. Also it is given that the vector magnitude of the slope will be equal to 1, so it is a unity slope or unit slope on both the endpoints, and we wanted to find out how to plot the equation of the hermit form of a cubic hermit cubic spline fit on in this particular situation. Okay, so what we try to do here is that we want to illustrate how to obtain the cubic spline in hermit form, and for simplicity we know that if we really consider the equation which is used for this purpose, Vx Vxt equals Vx 0 corresponding to one end point times of 1 minus 3t square plus twice t cube, and I am just borrowing this equation of the derivation that we had done while actually looking at hermit cubic spline fit, time plus Vx 1 times of 3t square minus twice t cube plus V dash x 0 times of t minus 2t square plus t cube plus v dash x 1 times of minus t square plus t cube. That is how you represent the Vx, and you already have formulations where you know that Vx 0 is actually equal to 1 and Vx 1 is equal to 3. From the first x axis coordinate points of the point A and B. Similarly, Vy 0 equals 2 and Vy 1 equals 1 from the y axis coordinates of the point A and B. Further, we also know that Vx dash 0, the slope at 0 is 1 cos of 60 degrees, where 1 is the magnitude of the tangent, and of course cos 60 is the x component of the slope or x component of the tangent, and similarly Vy 0, which is 1 times of sine of 60, and in this particular case again you have Vx 1, Vx 1 dash equals to you have 30 degrees as the slope at the point corresponding to x equal to 1, the other end of the particular fit, so it is 1 cos of 30 degrees. And Vy dash 1 corresponding to 1 sine of 30 degrees. So given so many different parameters here, can we really put it back into this equation fit and see how it goes? Okay. So let us just do that in the next step. We have, I am just going to write down all the parameters once again. So Vx 0 is 1, Vx 1 equals 3, Vx 1 or Vy 1, or let us put it 0 in the same sequence, this is equal to 2 Vy 1 equals to 1, and similarly you have Vx dash 0 equals 1 cos of 60 degrees, Vy dash 0 equals 1 sine of 60 degrees, and similarly Vx dash 1 equals 1 cosine 30 degrees and Vy dash 1 equals 1 sine of 30 degrees. Given this expression, you want to just solve for Vx, which is equal to Vx as a function of t parametric form, Vx 0 times of 1 minus 3t square plus twice t cube plus Vx 1 times of 3t square minus twice t cube plus Vx dash 0 times of t minus twice t square plus t cube plus Vx dash 1 times of minus t square plus t cube, borrowed from earlier. So just putting the values, the different values of Vx0, Vx1, Vx dash 0 and Vx dash 1, we get Vxt as a function of t, parametric form, equals 1 times of 1 minus 3 t square plus twice t cube plus 3 times of 3 t square minus 2 t cube plus 2 t cube plus the Vx dash half times of the coefficient in t, which is, which is t minus 2 t square minus 2 t square plus t cube plus Vx dash 1, which is root 3 by 2 times of minus t square plus t cube. So if you want to algebraically solve this further, we are left with Vx, an expression for Vx as 1 plus half t plus 5 minus root 3 by 2 t square plus root 3 by 2 minus 7 by 2 t cube. So this is how you can calculate the value of Vx given a certain value of t. Now if t varies between 0 and 1 in the increments of, let's say, 0.2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8 and so on and so forth, this is 1 on one side and 0 on another. So you can actually have the mapping of the function Vx and all these different values to extrapolate the local domain in this whole global function, and that way you can formulate a good fit. So this is only the x coordinate though, we have to do a same job for the y coordinate. And so similarly, we can write Vy as Vyt, which is actually Vy0 in a similar manner, times of 1 minus 3 t square plus 2 t cube. And this equation really has been borrowed from the previous module where we arrived at how this equation comes into existence. Vy1 times of 3 t square minus twice t cube plus, in a similar manner, V dash y0 times of t minus twice t square plus t cube plus Vy dash 1 times of minus t square plus t cube. That's how you calculate the Vyt. And in this particular module, again, substituting the different values of Vy0 to be 2, Vy dash 0 to be 1 sine of 60, which is root 3 by 2. Again, Vy1 to be equal to 1 and Vy dash 1 to be equal to sine of 30. Which is actually half. So we have to, now we can actually get another equation of similar type in y. So you can say that Vy as a function of t becomes equal to 2 times of 1 minus 3 t square plus twice t cube plus Vy, which is 1, Vy1 is 1 times of 3 t square minus twice t cube plus Vy dash 0, which is root 3 by 2. Times of t minus twice t square plus t cube plus Vy dash 1, which is half times of minus t square plus t cube. So again, simplifying in a similar manner as before, the Vy comes as a function of t as twice plus root 3 by 2 t plus minus 7 by 2 minus root 3 t square plus 5 by 2 plus root 3 by 2 t cube. That's how it can be arrived at. And so this can report the y value for the function, where the x value was earlier reported by this particular expression. So now if you really want to verify whether what we are saying is true, let us look at the end conditions. I'm just going to write down both the equations again in the next page. So Vx in our case was obtained as 1 plus half t plus 5 minus root 3 by 2 t square plus root 3 by 2 minus 7 by 2 t cube. And Vy was obtained again as twice plus root 3 by 2 t plus minus 7 by 2 minus root 3 square of t plus 5 by 2 plus root 3 by 2 q of t. So, at the outset, let us just find out what would be the v x and y 0 by substituting the value of t equal to 0, and similarly find out what is v x at t equal to 1 and so on v y at t equal to 1. So, we get here by substituting t equal to 0 that v x becomes 1 and v y becomes 2, and if you substitute 1, and then this expression becomes 1 plus half plus 5 minus root 3 by 2 plus root 3 by 2 minus 7 by 2, which eventually boils down to 1 plus 5 minus 3 is again 3, and the other expression boils down to 2 plus root 3 by 2 minus 7 by 2 minus root 3 plus 5 by 2 plus root 3 by 2, putting the value of t equal to 1. So, these strike off and you are left with 2 minus 1, which is 1. So, therefore, this replicates the end conditions. You already know that point 1 corresponding to t equal to 0 was at the coordinate point 1, 2, and point B at t equal to 1 was at the coordinate point 3, 1. That is how we initially started with, as seen here. Okay. So, therefore, whatever fit we have done through this whole process is actually yielding us the data, particularly for the end conditions corresponding to t equal to 0 and t equal to 1. So, obviously, for a value of t varying between 0 and 1, and as I illustrated before, 0.2, let us say increments of 2, 0.4, 0.6, 0.8, so on and so forth, you should be able to fit this equation appropriately. Okay. And this is how you can actually do the fit. You can see the values of different values of t with a slope of 1, you know, taken, and this is how the fit results from the slope. Okay. So, here of course, if I look at the slope at the point A, which again, you know, by the Hermit cubic spline polynomial can be written down as v y dash by v x dash at the point t equal to 0. So, I can actually physically calculate what is the value of the slopes by looking at what is our v dash x and v y dash from this expression. So, the slope becomes half plus twice 5 minus root 3 by 2 t plus thrice root 3 by 2 minus 7 by 2 t square, and similarly this becomes root 3 by 2 plus twice minus 7 by 2 minus root 3 t plus thrice 5 by 2 plus root 3 by t or 2 t square. And if I substitute the value of t equal to 0, for example, v x dash becomes equal to half and v y dash becomes equal to root 3 by 2. So, therefore, in this particular expression, v y dash by v x dash comes out to be root 3 by 2 by half, which is root of 3, which is actually the truth that the slope at A is corresponding to tan of 60 degrees, which is root 3. Okay. And similarly, we can calculate what is the slope at B by looking at the v y dash by v x dash expression corresponding to t equal to 1. So, if I substitute the value of t equal to 1 in these two equations here, the v x dash and the v y dash now changes, because now t is 1, and here we get half plus 10 minus root 3 plus 3 root 3 by 2 minus 21 by 2. Again, the VY dash becomes equal to root 3 by 2 plus twice minus 7 by 2 minus root 3 plus thrice 5 by 2 plus root 3 by 2. Okay? So these come out to be, so this is equal to root 3 by 2 and this is again equal to half. And this can again be extended here as half divided by root 3 by 2 and it comes out to be 1 by root 3. Obviously this corresponds to tan of 30 degrees and it obviously means that at B the slope is corresponding to 30 degrees. So we are kind of mapping both the information that we had in the question related to the coordinates at the point corresponding to t equal to 0 and t equal to 1 and also the slopes at the point t equal to 0 and t equal to 1 in this particular expression. And as you can see here, the whole map is between two such points here. Here the coordinates start from 1, 1. So you have 2, 1 as or 1, 2 as one of the coordinates from which the fit starts. And here probably the slope as you can see is actually 60 degrees and the other coordinate is at the point 3, 1 again. And here the slope is corresponding to 30 degrees. Okay, so that's pretty much how with a magnitude of 1 of the slope you can have a curve fit. Now the question is, can I be able to vary this curve so that we can map different topologies? And the solution for that is, if supposing the magnitude of the slope now is, and you can try it yourself, magnitude of the slope is varied, you can have a family of curves mapping different curvatures between the point A and the point B. And it can be looked at here how by just the change of slope from 1 to 2 to 3 to 6 to 12 you have variety of topologies or variety of curves, you know. And so the idea is to now be able to fit whatever curve you have to any of these family of curves and that would be the corresponding fit between the point 2 and 3. Supposing we were to define a complex topology between the point A and B, that is 1, 2 and 3, 1, between these one particular curve maybe corresponding to let's say the slope equal to 6 would be found to be very close to the actual topology with less with very less error. And so this can rightly map the topology correctly. Okay, so that is the whole basis of doing such a curve fit. So this brings us to an end of the Hermit cubic spline fit. But the problem with Hermit spline fit is, as you know, that the information needed is not only the endpoints but also the slope. And slope is not very easy to measure on a realistic scale when we are doing metrology. And so therefore we move altogether into a different domain of the curve fit, which is called fitting of the Bezier function, which we'll do in the next module. So thank you as of now.